your 11 Insta-Weather Plus forecast with Chief Meteorologist Tom Tasselmeyer.
There are some showers on the eastern shore this afternoon, but not the long, steady rains that those farmers need. We're just seeing some pop-up showers and thunderstorms down near the Bay Bridge, over toward Graysonville, up into parts of Kent County. Also in northern Anne Arundel now, a couple of isolated showers have developed. Same thing in the western part of Howard County and up around Damascus in Montgomery County. The first showers to really kind of come in our area dropped out of Pennsylvania through Baltimore and Hartford and Carroll counties, and those appear to be winding down at this hour. So we'll see a few of these for the next couple of hours until just after sunset, and then they'll pretty much diminish and fall apart. And if your neighborhood gets one, you might get a pretty good downpour. Other than that, most areas will stay dry. That's kind of indicated when you look at the almanac. Officially at BWI Marshall and at the Inner Harbor, no rain to measure yet today, although other areas, as we've seen, have had a little bit of a shower move by. Record amount of rain, 2.29 inches back in 1942. We hit 90 at the airport, so we're back to 90 degrees, and that is a couple above the normal of 88. But thankfully, no threat to break the record today, because this record, 107 in 1936, it's the hottest all time ever officially measured in Baltimore, and it came on a day when the entire state of Maryland was baking. We set state records at Cumberland and Frederick, 109 degrees on July the 10th, 1936. Baltimore's all-time record at 107. And it wasn't the same year, but it was the same day, a little bit earlier, 1913, July the 10th, Death Valley, North American record, 134 degrees on July the 10th that day. All this to say, when you hit July the 10th, you have hit the hot part of the summer all across North America. Temperatures right now, though, are not too bad. Around the Beltway, low 80s, up I-95 into Harford County, about 82 at Edgewood, 83 around Columbia. Up around Westminster, where a shower went by, they cooled into the low 70s. And some of the areas north and west of us, once these showers diminish and the skies try to clear a little bit overnight, maybe we see some low 60s in some of the cooler northern suburbs, closer to 70 downtown, light southeast winds, and just that slight chance for an isolated shower through the early evening hours. High pressure coming out of the Great Lakes, tracking toward New England. It'll stay in control of our weather for the next couple of days, with all the real stormy weather lined up along the front that broke the heat wave and then stalled through the Carolinas. And that's the focus of the strongest thunderstorms. South of there, that's where the searing heat and humidity still exist. And then up into the western part of the country, we're seeing some high heat too. That is Reno, Nevada right now at 101 degrees. Salt Lake City hit 101 earlier, 110 right now in Phoenix. So the heat, the worst of it is out west for the time being. Partly cloudy skies during the day tomorrow. Again, like today, a few pop-up thunderstorms late in the afternoon. High temperatures 84 to 89. Light winds out of the east or southeast on the bay. Waves around a foot. Western Maryland, risk of a thunderstorm tomorrow. But look at the cooler temperatures, 74 to 75 degrees. Next couple of days up around Deep Creek Lake. Eastern shore locations, you got a shower tracking through a few locations today. I think we'll see less activity on Wednesday and Thursday. And down at the coast, Ocean City, a thunderstorm possible tomorrow, then partly cloudy to wrap up the work week down that way. See the temperatures 75 to 79 degrees. Tomorrow, 87. We'll stay there Thursday. Upper 80s Friday. Couple of hit-and-miss thunderstorms over the weekend with highs right around 90, and temperatures stay near normal early next week.